Justin Trudeau is sending 250 peacekeepers to the UN mission in Mali. The air task force is going to consist of 6 helicopters and members of the Canadian Armed Forces to help with medical evacuation and transportation of troops. Conservatives have always supported the brave men and women who serve us in uniform. The brave men and women of the Canadian Armed Forces are always trained, prepared, and ready to do anything that the government of Canada asks them to do. But let's be clear. The mission in Mali is the most deadly UN peacekeeping mission in the world. Over 162 peacekeepers have been killed since the mission started in 2014. Mali is a war zone. There is no peace to keep. Not only are we dealing with insurgents, military coups, and separatists, but we also have numerous terrorist organizations who are equipped and willing to kill peacekeepers. Justin Trudeau has not been honest with Canadians, and he has failed to tell us as parliamentarians exactly what our troops are going to be doing in Mali, how much it's going to cost, and whether or not this is in Canada's national interest. Unfortunately, this appears like Justin Trudeau is trying to curry favor so he can win his seat at the UN Security Council.
It was a failure of all of us. It was our collective failure. The list I have given, we all failed Rwanda.
The lessons that Canada has learned in UN missions in Rwanda and Somalia should be reason enough for us to question whether we want Canadian troops under UN command with some bureaucrat in New York calling the shots and rules of engagement which handcuff our troops. Justin Trudeau has left many questions unanswered. And that's why we as conservatives are demanding a debate and a vote on the deployment of Canadian troops to this UN mission in Mali. Conservatives will always stand up for our troops and make sure they're used in a responsible manner that is in Canada's best interest, not in Justin Trudeau's political self-interest.